that is most serious, because it will bind you together for life in a relationship so close and so intimate that it will profoundly influence your whole future. That future, which with its hopes and disappointments, its successes and its failures, its pleasures and its pains, its joys and its sorrows, is hidden from your eyes. You know that these elements are mingled in every life and are to be expected to grow. It's a bad knowing that is before you. You take each other for better or for worse, for richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health and in death. Truly, then, these words are most serious. It's a beautiful tribute to your undoubted faith in each other, but recognizing the full import, you are nonetheless so willing and ready to pronounce them. And because these words involve such solemn obligations, it is most fitting that you rest in that security of your wedded life of the great principle of success. And so you begin your married life by the voluntary and complete surrender of your individual lives in the interest of that deeper and wedded life that you are to have in common. Henceforth, you belong entirely to each other. You will be one in mind, one in heart, and one in affections. And whatever sacrifices you make hereafter be required to make to serve this common life, always make them generously. Sacrifice is usually difficult and irksome. Only love can make it easy, and perfect love can make it a joy. We are willing to give it for a proportion as we love. And when love is perfect, the sacrifice is complete. God so loved the world that he gave his only Son, and the Son so loved us that he gave himself for our salvation. Great love that this man had, that a man laid down his life for his friends. A greater blessing can come to your married life than pure conjugal love, loyal.
consolas of their spells. See what that brings you, spiritite, bless you. Etsa itum pari pro eo, ut ilum sanctificat. Mundans lavatro aqua inter vobit, ut exhibiret ipse sibi gloriosa ecclesia. Non abentem maculam maturugam at aliquibus mons, sed ut sit sancta et immaculata. Ita et vivi debent diligere consoles fluans, ut corpora sua, qui suam solem dirigit, ipsum dirigit. Nero animum quam carnem suam odio abuit, sed nutrit et foret eam, sicut et Christus ecclesia, qui in membros sumus corporis eius, de carne eius et de ossibus eius. Proteum quod homo patem et matrem suam, et adorabit uxori suae, et erunt duo in carne pura. Sacramentum hoc magnum est, ego aptem dico in Christo et in ecclesia. Verunt amen et vos singuli, unus quisque ut sorem suam, sicut se ipsum dirigat, ut sora trentine ad erum suam.
subject to their husbands as to the Lord, and for the husband is the head of the wife, as Christ is the head of the church. He is the Savior of his body. Therefore, as the church is subject to Christ, so also let the wives be to their husbands in all things. Husbands, love your wives, as Christ also loved the church, and delivered himself up for it, that he might sanctify and cleanse it by the laver of water in the word of life, that he might present unto himself a glorious church, that heaven's spotted or wrinkle, or any such thing, but that it should be a holy and without blemish. So also ought men to love the wives as their own bodies. He that loveth his wife loveth himself, for no man ever hated his own flesh, but nourished and cherished it, as also Christ God at the church. For we are members of his body and his flesh, and of his bones. For this cause shall a man leave his father and mother, and shall cleave to his wife, and they shall be two in one flesh. This is a great sacrament, and making reference to Christ and to the church. Nevertheless, let every one of you in particular love his wife as himself, and let the wife fear her husband. We may stand down for the Holy Gospel of St. Matthew. At that time, the Pharisees came to Jesus, tempting him and saying, "Is it lawful for a man to put away his wife for her cause?" Who answered and said to them, "Have you not read that he who made man from the beginning made a male and female?" And he said, "For this cause shall a man leave father and mother, and shall cleave to his wife, and they two shall be in one flesh. Therefore, now they are not two, but one flesh. What therefore God hath joined together, let not man put asunder." We may sit down. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Ghost. Amen. If there is one advice that I'd like to give the newlyweds, is develop your marriage in such a way that God will be proud of you. This is a marriage, and this is a great sacrament, because it signifies the union of Christ and his church. In such a way that both of them are not inseparable, and the man becomes part of God, and the man and the woman become one in such a way that they belong one to another. The man represents Christ, and as Christ is to give himself up daily as a sacrifice of love for his wife. If we think about what Christ did at the cross, what he said, "No man loveth another more than he who gives his life for his friend." And this is what Christ is asking to do, not just to the newlyweds, but also to all men here that are married, to give up themselves as a sacrifice for their wives, and yet in return, the wives to be subject to the man. This is chaos, this is bananas to the world, this is nonsense, because the nonsense that the world is just about being dependent on a really husband. Blah, 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 blah. No. But this makes no sense, and this is the number of God. Once we start reversing the roles of man and woman as God intended to be, then we're going to have the chaos in which we live right now. But yet, if we are faithful to those rules, to God, to marriage, to our vows, to our prayers, God is always faithful to us, and he's always going to give you that which you need. I'm not going to tell you that marriage is easy. No, it's not. And you can ask anybody here. I preach used to say, happy wife, happy life. No wife, better life. But, of course, but it's going to be difficult, because temptation is always going to be there. You're going to have an enemy, the devil, the flesh, and the world. And they're going to try to break that bond of you together, because the devil is afraid of good marriages, good holy marriages, because he knows that if there's good marriages, then there's going to be holy people of God. So keep this in mind always. Marriage
Thank you.
we have